pays you respect, pays you money also. Right. And when you take a problem, you have to know that what is the fundamental problem. What is the fundamental problem you have to solve in that. Fundamental problem is what are the basic theories in that. Fundamental theory in that problem, right? And what has been done before and why. People, what people have done before and why they have done things, right? And how they achieved it and what they achieved, right? And what are seemingly undoable. For example, apparently you found that it has not been done before, okay? Then you should focus on that thing, because you have to find the ways. You know, there are, every paper has a loophole. I tell you, information security, because we are people of the security, human makes and human breaks. This is the saying. We are the people who make the systems. We are the people who make the you break the system. Hackers, who are the hackers? The human. So every paper has, you know, undoable thing which they have not adhered to. So we have to find that thing. We have to find that there must be something, there must be some clue, there must be something we should focus on and we can write on a paper. And today I was reading one paper in IEEE signal processing letters, and one person proposed a very, very good technique, and it was, you know, beyond the imagination of some signal processing people, that what excellent mathematics he has proposed for this thing. But later on, that I just saw down that there was a crypt analysis of that paper, means that code was broken by some other scientist. So this is the thing. So you have to find, it means that the person who is breaking the code of other person, he is trying to understand, to comprehend that thing and coming up with the undoables in that paper, right? And understand your strength and weaknesses. You have to do SWOT analysis of yourself. If you don't know that what is your strength, if you don't know what is your weakness, then how can you come up? And very important thing is interest. Like here I have written, what is interest? There is a very good saying of Chinese Confucius, that if you want to do something in your life, do that thing in which you have interest. Then later on you don't have to do any other things. If you will have interest in something, then you will do from your heart. And then you will not have to do other things. You will not have to go here and there, hanky-panky, like this kind of things, right? And being a researcher, you have to be open-minded person, okay? You have to be critical also and open-minded, because you are not only dealing with the mathematics problem, because mathematics, one x plus y is equal to z, then you can prove it by putting values that 1 plus 1 is equal to z, then it is z is equal to 2, then you put some, substitute some values, then you get the equal equation. But in this engineering problem, we have not this kind of things. There is a trade-off between speed, accuracy, okay? There is a trade-off between security and accuracy. There is a trade-off, so many trade-off. For example, you bought a AC, you bought some fridge, it will work till 50 degree centigrade. It's a trade-off. What about 55 degree? Some you know, companies, Dolens or Samsung, and some companies are coming up with the new, it will work to 55 or 56 degree, like this. So there is a trade-off always in the security also, in every field, in engineering. Every engineering field has a trade-off between speed, accuracy, between cost and something, you know, this kind of stuff. And you have to be critical mind. This is very important. When you are reading a paper, when you are doing some research, you have to be critic. That you have to critic other person. Otherwise, you cannot do anything. Okay? When you read others, it is equally important to understand what circumstances it does not work as in which it works. You will see, of course, in some times that proposed framework or that idea will not work. You have to focus on that. Why it will not work on that? So I am coming up with this thing which it will work for. Like I cannot share one thing, but I tell you that recently I found a paper which is published by IEEE Transactions in Consumer Electronics. Then they are proposing a new solution for authentication of a person. But I found a trade-off in that, and I am coming up with a new solution. So you, how? When I relate the things, when I saw that it can be improved, there is a loophole, then I will propose my own solution, and then I will write paper. It will be published, of course. When you find a trade-off, when you find a loophole in that paper, then you should write it, write down. Okay, and then you should relate it with the real problems, and then you should propose your own protocol in that and try to submit that paper into the same transaction which has already been published before, right? For example, somebody has published paper in IEEE transaction on consumer electronics, then you should also, if you find some loophole, then you can submit that paper to that same transaction, then it will be easily published. this is I am giving you the, you know, experience, my experience. Some loophole, maybe some problem in that, because in security we normally use the, you know, loophole kind of words, like security hole. There is a security hole from where you can, you know, break the system. Then you should focus on that. And if you cannot identify such scenario, then it means you are not understanding the problem of paper. Whenever you are reading a paper, if you cannot, if you are not, you know, identifying the such scenario, it means that you are not understanding that paper. This is the easiest formula. If you cannot identify such scenario, if you cannot understand how it is working or why it is working, in which scenario it will be okay or not, then you are, if you understand, then it means you are understanding the whole paper. Otherwise, you are not understanding the paper. You are not understanding the whole framework. And confusion is research. This is some questions we ask ourselves when we are loaded with the mathematics. I will talk about the double E, because we are mostly engineers here. I have learned all the mathematics and I am loaded with discrete mathematics, I am loaded with probability, and I am loaded with the, you know, partial differential equation and information theory. But how to propose my solution? How to come up? I am very good mathematician, for example. I am not, I am not very good mathematician, I am just an engineer. That I am very good mathematician, then I cannot solve all the problems. Mathematics is not the panacea for all the diseases or all the, you know, problems. I still don't have a clue what to do in research. I have done many courses. This question you ask yourself, I used to ask myself when I was doing, okay, I did, every semester I used to do 5 courses. Okay, 4 semester I studied in masters. Then I have done around 20 courses. But how to start research? I have learned every course, but I don't know how to find the research area. This question you ask yourself. And maybe some people are in this phase these days. You are in this phase because I know that you are trying to solve a problem these days. And where in the world is research topic? Where it is hidden? It's a hidden truth. And I have read all the papers out from the journals and conferences, but I cannot find any problem. How? This is about your creativity. Can I do research now when I am loaded, fully loaded with all the things? There is no way you can cope with all of them. It's very important. Majority of the published work could be junk for you. This is very important thing I am telling you. You go to the IEEE, you go just write down, and then you will find a lot of papers, conference paper and many here and there. Google, you can search. You can search many other, you know, publishers. A lot of papers will be junk for you. I am not saying that their work is junk. For you, it will be junk for you. Then, and can cause brain damage. This happened to me also. When I was doing that, a lot of papers, I cannot know that which paper I should focus on, which paper I should read. A lot of papers, thousands of papers. Just how many papers you know on the IEEE? Are you familiar with the IEEE? How many papers do they have and documents? 2 million documents on the IEEE Explore, more than even 2 million, 3,000 something, maybe statistics of the morning, this morning. So how can you, it will not damage your brain. Minimum, I will damage my brain. How to search useful and relevant material, where to search? This is very important thing. Google is not the panacea for doing research, I am telling you. Because normally people search papers on the Google, it will give you everything. It will give you some sites, it will give you the pictures of Honolulu or Gold Coast of Australia. So you have to be focused, you have to search where you have to find the important and respective papers and related papers and relevant papers. And the most important thing is classic paper. Do you know what is the definition of classic paper? Yeah, this, which is the breakthrough paper, which is setting the trend for the people who are going to start the research. It is called classic paper. You have to focus on the classic paper in your field. For example, I give you the example of biometrics, because I am the biometric researcher, so I will give you most of the examples from that or other fields also. That biometric, when I was going to start my PhD, my professor gave me the survey paper. That was a, you know, classic paper for me, a very good paper for me. And there was one more classic paper written by Anil Jain. Anil Jain is a very big scientist of biometrics from Michigan State University. And I started reading that and I got a lot of ideas from that. And one paper was published in IBM Systems General. It's a very one of the very good transactions of in the world in systems engineering, IBM systems general, and I got one